Hey, how's it going? So, I got a call I wasn't able to take. I don't know if you can see this here. So, here's the screen. So, I don't know if you can see it because of the resolution, but it says Limit 3 expires at the end of January and used by January 30th. And so, to receive items, log into game with the same Google account. It says Get Item. So, I did the Get Item, and did it redeem? So I do Get Item, and then it says installing you. Oh, I already own this. Okay, so I did get it. There's an error. I already own it. Okay. So, but anyway, you can get rewards and stuff like that. I do have a purchase history. So anyway, I spent about $105 in January. I got $5 on NBA Jams, and then here's all the. Let's see. Oh, that's the. That's the Google. These are the shows and stuff that we used to watch. We got the movies and the MTV shows and the stuff like that. But I guess it doesn't. Somehow that's the problem with going between the two is somehow I spent $105 in January, but it really only has this $5.40 charge. So all the other $100 is on the iCloud or the Apple account. And so, I basically, I guess it's not, I guess it's the Google backup or whatever. I did have another reward. Somehow, let's go to account. Account. It's a little bit tough. It said I had gold or something. And then I don't know what happened. I said a claim. And then, so here I got the speed up chest. So the speed up chest should be with the game. And then, redeem promo code. Oh, I don't have a promo code. Okay. Somehow it had all this other Google Play points and stuff. Play points. Here we go. Okay, so you can, perks. Okay, gold prize. Win something every week. Expires in 5 days. I'm going to claim. You see that? See what's inside. Went up to 200 play points. Okay. I got 200 play points. All right, that's great. Okay, a prize will be waiting for you soon. I mean, I'll check out ways to earn points faster. So, obviously a points program, okay? So, I've got, I got to get up higher or whatever. So I do have some points, though. I have made 5 purchases of 99 cents or more, or three of them. I got 2 purchases left. So let's see if we can use them. Okay, so if you got 100 points, you can get $1 Google Play credit. Since I have 600 points, 1,000 you get. So I'm going to try to get the $5 Google Play credit. Okay. So sometimes this works, sometimes it doesn't. I do have over 500 points. So I'm going to hit this here, and I'm going to use points. Okay, so my play credit balance is $5. So I can tell my man I'm going to get $1 for the last, so I'll have 8 points left. So I use points. So I have $6. I got 8 points left. And that's great. So I got a let's see where I can find that balance here. Account. Rewards. My apps and games. Let's see if we can find another. Let's see. So the auto updates, some of the updates have been happening, some of them haven't. So YouTube updated, Microsoft, which I don't actually use that much anymore. Google TV updated, which I didn't download. Google Photos, all this stuff. Google Drive, all this stuff. So some of this stuff kept updating again and again and again. I thought, wow, so we're still waiting on this to download, even though I've claimed the speed up kits. You got the library. So, and then they do have the movies and TV. So I could actually get a movie or a TV. I'll show you. Let's see, let's go to games. See, for you, it's hard to find your library stuff. And here's all the other apps. So we can try to get some of the social networking stuff going on here. It is pretty good, it's pretty fun. So I did get to play NBA Jams, that was great. Even though it was slow on the transfer, right? So, some of this stuff, I get real mad sometimes, real mad and happy and what like that, so. So I'm trying to think. Let's see the play pass. I don't know. Sometimes you can do the play pass or you don't do the play pass. It's always been kind of a big deal. When I grew up with, Macintosh computers and PC, a lot of the games and stuff were hard to get on Macintosh. And even just TV, watching YouTube TV and all that stuff. I'm going to wait and see if I can get the other apps. Because I don't know why this one isn't downloaded. Maybe they changed it on Google for Play and it's different on iPhone, Apple, I don't know. But it was the same game, so. So we'll see what the top charts are. Disney Plus, real popular. And like I was saying, all those channels on the TV were Discovery Plus. So, TV. So yeah, I'm gonna exit out of here. Oh, redeem. What can I redeem? Oh, it's for a promo code. I don't have a promo code. But I should have. I want to see that $6 on the Google Play. Play points. Account. Rewards. Purchase history. So I got my play credit, my $5 play credit, and my $1 play credit. And I want to see where I can apply that. I can open movies and TV and go to shop. It's a little bit slow. And you can see they have a different setup here, which maybe is clear or not as clear. We can do kind of the compare. I guess it auto-updated there, so it's not as distorted. The one up here was a lot clearer when I went into it, and now it looks like it's been adjusted. Okay, we'll hit it here, and then screen mirroring, so. Yeah, so then we go into the app. A lot of this overlapping internet, right? So. Oh, no media selected. I have to select media. Okay, let's do Tenet. Watch the trailer. See if it goes into it. I want it. So they're preparing. But let's see how it. And see the resolution all is just sort of basic there. I don't get to watch it on here at the same time. I guess that's the difference.
It'll open the right doors. Some of the wrong ones too.
It actually is looking a lot clearer in the app as opposed to just doing it in total.
Use it carefully. I do. I need some idea of the threat we face.
As I understand it, were trying to prevent World War III.
I'm not saying I'm getting here.
No. Something worse.
This is a lot clearer than what we got in the rest of the device.
Mike's bringing in.
He's gonna play Batman soon.
No. He can communicate with the future.
This is basically coming in HD now.
No.
Inversion.
Hey, Mr. Portrait. You're not shooting, but you're catching it.
Well, I've seen too much. Well, we'll try and keep up.
Your duty transcends national interests. This is about survival.
So yeah, this is getting really good quality here.
Hold up, finally. I thought you were going to say nuts.
So I gotta get back into this. I feel like that's a lock screen. That looks really clear right there.
Yeah. Hasn't happened yet.
There are people in the future who need us. We need a tenant.
We need to save them.
See, this is the screencast from Google Play, which obviously has much higher resolution than just sort of the standard screencast from Google. Obviously, if you're going to watch a movie, you want it to be clear, right?
Well, how big a plane? That part is a little dramatic.
Alright, so as you can tell, the difference being ready to cast from the app, okay, versus, let's see if I can get back to, in sort of from Google Home, okay, trying to cast from Google Home on sort of whatever network you have. See, now it still says stop casting. But it's not. But then it hasn't not actually interrupted. So that's sort of one of the things you have. You know, sort of when you look at Apple versus Google, right? Apple seems to have one app integrated throughout all its products, right? As they say, you know, what is the new product, right? When Apple loses that functionality, right? You know, a part of a product goes away, or it doesn't work, or they don't add it. You know, in terms of like the Apple products that hook up to a TV. You know, does it need to have a hard drive? Does it not need to have a hard drive? Do we add the hard drive back to a type of thing? When you're talking about Google and Microsoft, right, you're talking about almost incompatibility between the same function, which in some ways should work across its devices. They seem to work incompatibly with each other, right? What I see here is, you know, in the Google Home, it says stop casting, right? So the implication there is that, you know, it's still casting. But as you saw, when I casted from this across the device, I get very low resolution and almost a distorted view, okay? When I go into Google Play, I activate a second Google Cast from the Google Play, which gets ideally HD there, okay? Now I come out of it, right? This appears to still be casting, but there is no casting on the screen. So I will do stop casting, then I will go back to it and cast my screen again, okay? And as you can tell, I don't know whether you want to call it the gradient. The gradient is much lower, okay? So in an ideal world, right, you would have exceptional functionality of both with almost an artistic choice between the two. But what we most likely find is, you know, interference and difficulty actually using you know, whatever it's for, right? You know, I'm thinking maybe extra vibrant colors or different sounds, right? What we end up with is a reduced gradient from the device. However, if we use the screen casting, okay, for specific movies, it elevates to the HD. And so, you know, if you were to call tech support or something, right, which everybody seems to get irritated with, they would pretty much just tell you on Google Home that that's the best it can be based on compatibility or, you know, your ability to broadcast on whatever, Wi-Fi or Bluetooth or whatever, right? You know, that's the best it can be. But when you change and you go into the Play Store, right, and you access that, you end up getting a much higher quality. So that's just some of the things that people get irritated with, and I think why a lot of people eventually switched from, you know, Microsoft, and which at the time Google wasn't around in 2000 when Steve Jobs came back and launched the, you know, OS X, which, you know, the best part of OS X was that the computer wouldn't crash, right? So you might have something like this in a Microsoft system, right? And if you have an incompatibility between one app and the other app, it crashes the entire device, computer, right? Your personal computer at home. So, you know, you had Steve Jobs have launched OS X, and the idea was is the computer would not crash, it would not freeze. You wouldn't have to unplug the device and plug it back in. You could seemingly restart the operating system if there was a problem and continue doing your work or whatever it was. If you were, you know, trying to do video or whatnot. I keep getting this device turning off. I thought I fixed that. So everything kind of went to Apple because you had all the functions across every device. You didn't have a lot of device. You had one, but across all the applications, right? You would go to, you know, your Apple icon or whatever like this, click, you know, screen mirror, and it would be, you know, the same really good quality across, you know, whatever app you used. You have the Microsoft problem of, you know, in the home app, I get low gradient. In the movie app, I get HD, you know. And then what would happen is when you tried to interact with both, you'd get a frozen computer and you couldn't use it anymore, or you'd have to delete it or reformat the hard drive or whatever else. So I don't know why I'm getting this to turn off so fast. A lot of this stuff is really easy to use to begin with, and then it gets to be sort of a maintenance problem. You have to keep maintaining it. You get the older guys, sort of the older business guys that make a lot of money, they say, oh, I can't deal with it. It takes too much time. Let somebody else deal with it all. And then they use less of the technology. It ends up being beneficial because it does end up becoming, you know, so tedious just to deal with everything. Netflix seemed to be an app that came with a device that can't be deleted. So I did disable it. I don't know why, paying for it and everything. A lot of these items, I don't exactly know, you know, what they do. I'm trying to basically find the, you know, the sort of the, how to set up everything. See, I'm not really into this stuff. These settings, I don't seem to have, you know, on the iPhone, you got so many different settings. So what I'm going to try to do is do the, settings right here. Advanced features. I don't. I will make and receive calls on this device. I'm not going to link it. I mean, see, it's a Samsung account, so I'm actually going to call and text on other. I think, I don't know, this might be, you know, you might be able to get some type of cellular with this. I don't know. It's got that back and forth. What is direct share? Okay, we're going to turn that off. Screenshots. Screenshots are great. Screenshot toolbar. It's in JPG. You have a screenshot toolbar down here. Side key. Call. Smart pop-up. A lot of this stuff, it's not exactly what I'm looking for. Open the cover to unlock the tablet. Okay, so we're going to turn that off. Book cover. I basically just don't want the screen to turn off. Screen lock. Home screen settings. Okay. Here we go. So we can see the difference here. You can see the distortion there, the difference in the playability. We get a much, it's slower, it's delayed, the gradient is significantly lower. In fact, it's not even playing from the home. Right? We're not even getting the playability here. It's almost like it's blocked out. You have to use the app up there, which gets you the HD quality. If you use the in-app, you get the better quality there. But you can see the image there, the lower gradient. See, it's much lower. We can look at the Dark Knight, the trailer. I don't even know if it'll play. You've got the Joker there for Heath Ledger. See, we're not even getting any playability here, right? If I use this, right, I can go into it, and it turns on in HD. See, we get the almost HD there. Now it looks like it's lower gradient. We'll see if it improves.
Where do we begin?
A year ago, these cops and lawyers wouldn't dare cross any of you. I mean, what happened?
So what are you proposing?
It's simple. Kill the Batman.
Well,
my car.
Bruce, this is Harvey Dent.
Rachel's told me everything about you.
I certainly hope not. You always told me that we'd be together. Did you mean it?
Bruce, don't make me your only hope for a normal life.
You're Alfred, right?
That's right, sir.
Any psychotic ex-boyfriends I should be aware of?
Oh, you have no idea.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Here tonight's entertainment.
Well, hello, beautiful. You look nervous.
I've seen how it would have to become to stop men like him.
The night is darkest just before the dawn. I promise you.
So the difference is I don't have functionality within the device. So I don't really know, you know, if I go back to something, what the next one is. Somehow I thought the Dark Knight, I guess there's Batman Begins. Let's do that one. I like Batman Begins. He's got to climb back into, he's got, you know, the training or whatever, sort of. This was such a fun movie. Oh, let's see. So I obviously don't have it here. I have to re-go to the cast. And we'll start it from the beginning. We got a little bit slow.
We travel the world.
The lower gradient. And then we'll see if it improves.
What you really fear is inside you. There is no turning back. The Ferret's death was not your fault. Training is nothing. The will is everything. If you make yourself more than just a man, if you devote yourself to an ideal, you become something else entirely. Are you ready to begin?
Get that dark lock screen. I really don't know how to fix that. I'll turn off this light. So then it goes back. Ow! Hold my elbow. Let's see. We'll go back to... Let's watch the third one, The Dark Knight Rises. I'll do all these. All these Christopher Nolan movies. They were, you know, sort of... It'll go back into cast.
Sound like you're looking for it.
I'm adaptable.
This is a lower.
What are you? I'm Gotham's Reckoning.
See, I'm on a different one, and then this is on this, which is fine.
Go.
mother warned me about getting into cars with strangers.
So I'm trying to go into the Inception trailer, but I can't get the trailer to play. So that's how some things just don't always see. Maybe I'm back on two trailers. I go to this trailer. I go to that trailer. It does not play. I go to cast. Can it play? The trailer to Inception doesn't play. Why does it not play? Some of this stuff just gets people a little bit too upset. I can't act. I don't actually have the play button on here. I can go to Interstellar, and that trailer has a button. So we'll watch Interstellar. The gradient has to come up.
What are you gonna do with it?
I'm gonna give it something socially responsible
to do. Can't we just let it go?
I think he's learning how to adapt, Murph.
Okay, let's mask up.
Like the rest of us.
This world's a treasure. It's been time to leave for a while now.
Your daughter's generation
will be the last to survive on Earth.
You're the best pilot we ever had.
Get out there.
Save the world.
Everybody ready to say goodbye to our solar system?
To our galaxy.
Here we go. Right here. We want to get down fast, don't we?
Actually, we want to get there in one piece.
Hang on.
Okay, so I do like watching some of his movies. I'll go back to Inception. I don't think the Inception trailer will play, but I remember The Matrix in 1998. It had such, you know, good HD and special effects. Gotta get a little bit clearer.
Cancer of this planet, and we are
save the world.
So what do you need? Guns. Lots of guns.
No one has ever done anything like this.
That's why it's going to work.
Buckle your seatbelt, Dorothy.
Here's Mission Impossible 2 with Tom Cruise. Watch a different one. Looks like it changed. The search changed when I closed it. Anyway, I will go back and see if in the Play Store, I will go back to the home and redo the stopcast, startcast. And then we'll see they get that lower gradient there. We'll exit out there. We'll go here. And we'll go to the Play Store. And I still am not able to download. So maybe I'm not allowed to download this. I don't really know. I'm still not able to get the game to load. So you see it there. Anyway, I'm going to end there. I hope you're doing well. I've been uploading these, so I hope you're doing good. And you can see the difference in picture, too. You have sounded the clear picture, much redder on there. So hope you're doing well. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.